Hey guys, hello. Welcome to Mishi Blue Tarot and welcome to my channel. As you can see, I'm back for all of you with another reading and another interesting question. It's interesting as per me because I've been thinking around those lines quite a bit. So yes, here I am. And firstly, to all of you, thank you so much for liking, subscribing, sharing, viewing, commenting. Everything that you've done for my channel, it really, really means a lot to me. And I hope that you continue to be attached to me, and I hope that I continue to bring in messages for all of you, and relevant messages and relevant topics for all of you, and you know, be able to answer your questions if there are any that you have. All right. So coming back to today's reading, what I'm going to look at it today is what is the significance of this connection in your life? So basically, I mean, this is a reading for people who, it need not be love related connection, it can be anything, okay? Like if you've come across someone off late and you feel a bond, or if you feel a weird pull, okay? It's that. It can be love also, just so that you get clarity about why this connection is here and what is its significance in your life. Okay, so we're going to look at that aspect of, you know, the connection today. So what is the significance of this connection in your life? And that's the question that we're looking at today. So now, as you can see that I have three piles here. Pile number one is the green aventurine, number two is clear quartz, and number three is the amethyst. Okay, so what you can do is think about your connection, think about your person, think about whatever this situation is. Okay, it can be anything. Just think about it, close your eyes, and pick your pile. Whichever pile attracts you the most, go ahead and pick it, because in this scenario, I feel it should be one pile, because I think that way messages will be precise. You can go ahead and choose whichever one is attracting you the most. Question again, what is the significance of this connection in your life? Okay, I will start with pile number one, the green aventurine. Okay. Put these aside. All right, so green aventurine. I don't know why I was pushed to do this question today, because I had been feeling very heavy energies of late, so I just thought of doing something like this for all of you. Let's see how much of it helps you guys. All right, so here we are, green aventurine. What is the significance of this connection in your life? All right. Ubuntu, compassion for others. Okay. Wedding, this situation involves marriage. Okay. Queen of Wands. Third chakra, Archangel Shamuel, Ace of Swords, the Emperor. Wow. Okay. One minute. I'm getting a lot of messages. Hmm. Okay, so since this is a general reading, guys, take how it resonates for you. When the two of you have met each other, okay, I see that one has toned down a bit. If your person was a very strict person, or if they were very, very feelingless, or they were very rigid, I am seeing that your presence has kind of toned them down a bit. And you both meeting is something destined, right? That's what I'm seeing. Destined, however you want to put it. I sense that this person is really charmed by you. Okay? This person is extremely attracted to your beauty, is extremely attracted to how powerful a personality you are. Okay? And I'm seeing that there are these, so here the wedding card that I see is basically telling me that, you know, such feelings are a little alien for your person. I think they had become very rigid in their life, and it's not something that they thought they would be able to do. Okay, but I'm seeing the solar plexus chakra, it's like, you know, literally on heat. So this does determine some sort of, you know, impatience, and at the same time fire. It's the golden color of the solar plexus. So it's basically, you know, you need to, it's an energy that has piled up around your person. Okay. And I'm seeing that these are new things in their overall persona. Okay. This is very new for them. All right. And it's like a path breaking event for them, like a breakthrough kind of a thing. And it suddenly softened them a bit. So the significance of this connection in your life is what I'm seeing is that your presence kind of softens, keeps this person a little soft. Otherwise, I see this person to be really very harsh. Okay. With the Emperor card, I feel this person was extremely rigid. My way or the highway kind of attitude, doesn't really care about anyone else. That kind of an energy is what I'm seeing. Okay. I also feel that somewhere, maybe in your past life or something, those who believe in past lives, I feel you both were married. Okay. And I'm seeing that the moment you guys have met each other, those feelings have kind of recognized each other. Okay. And if you, I don't know, like if your person is a very rigid person with this Emperor, I feel in front of you, they might be a little coy, I'm saying. They might be a little, you know, more, a little soft, a little gentle and welcoming towards you. But in general, that is not their personality. Okay. I'm seeing, suddenly, you know, love, I mean, I don't know if this is love or anything. This is just somebody's presence triggering some feelings. Okay. These feelings are very different. These feelings are very, I would say, new for your person. I'm sensing newness. Okay. And this third chakra, Archangel Shamuel card is literally telling me that this presence of yours, okay, is being channelized around the solar plexus by them. They feel you around their solar plexus. So this is getting a little spiritual. I'm so sorry, but that's the insight that I'm getting here. It's triggering your person's chakra alignment, literally. And it's basically bringing them back in balance. Maybe because of their rigidness, they had kind of stopped a lot of feelings, stopped themselves from feeling a lot of things. Okay, maybe because they did not want to, maybe because their upbringing was like that, or maybe they just think that, you know, being emotional is not the way here. I'm seeing that kind of an energy. So maybe because of these kind of feelings, they've just become a little rigid. And the reason why this connection has come, I'm seeing more than from for you, it's for them. It's basically your presence kind of making them a little grounded, a little softer, a little emotional, a little compassionate. Okay, so you as a person, I think, just be the way you are. It's like the feminine calling the masculine, or vice versa, guys, whoever's watching this. The feminine call is very, very attractive for your person. If this is a girl watching, and if this is a man watching, I think, you know, your woman, I feel, is kind of bringing in or helping you become stable. So I'm getting masculine and feminine energies, guys. So just understand, if this is a man watching, then I feel that you're becoming a little softer because of this person. And if this is a woman watching, I feel that your presence is making your person a little more softer, compassionate, lesser rigid than what they were. Okay, so it's a beautiful combination. The synergy that I'm seeing here in this card, third chakra card, is beautiful. It's leading to golden light, which is awakening, okay, which is light, which is glory, which is knowledge. So it's beautiful. It's just awakening some feelings which were hidden or probably were stuffed up a little too much, and they had to come out. So it's a good pile, I see. The significance of this connection in your life, as I said, if you're a woman, I'm seeing you softening your person. And if you're a man, I'm seeing that this person in your life. So any which ways, I'm seeing an energy, yin and yang, basically. So definitely, whoever you will know if you're the masculine or the feminine, take it the way it is. You guys are just balancing each other out. Okay? You guys are balancing each other out. Yeah, so that's what I have for pile number one, green aventurine, guys. Let me know in the comments if this resonated with you. Also, private reading details are open, are available on the description, so you can reach out to me. Just one heads up, I will not be doing video recorded readings for a week, but after that I will resume again. Audios are most welcome and video calls are most welcome. I'll be putting up a post about the same as well. And whenever you're watching this, please, please, please take care of yourself, take care of your health, stay safe, and make sure that you are taking the required precautions with the current scenario. I hope all of you are doing well. Bye. Okay. Clear quartz. Let us see. What is the significance of this connection in your life? Okay, so what I saw for pile number one, I picked up both, like as in, what is the significance for your person and what is the significance for you? So I picked up on both the energies. It can be possible I might just land up doing the same here, but let's see what comes out. But my endeavor is going to be to check what is the significance of this connection in your life. So here we are, clear quartz. Mirak, embrace oneness with the universe. Separation. Time apart from your partner is on the horizon. Strength. Angel of strength again. Wow. Okay. Seven of cups. Knight of pentacles. All right, just give me a minute. Okay, So pile number two, clear quartz. Okay. So the significance of this connection in your life. All right. First things first, as I said, I might pick up on energies of both of you, like significance of this connection in your person's life and in your life. So I am seeing, just take it how it resonates. I'm seeing that one of you in this situation was in a toxic relationship which was killing you from within. Okay. It was literally there for the heck of it, and you were probably living in it, or your person was living in it because of lack of strength. So this connection is like an angel of strength in your life and in your person's life. Okay. I'm seeing mostly this could be your person's energy, but in some cases it could be your energy also. Maybe you were in a toxic marriage or in a toxic connection, which was not really, serving the purpose. Like, as in, you did not know where this was going. With the Seven of Cups here, I feel you were just like all in your head. You did not understand where is this leading. You did not figure out that, and the universe was giving you a lot of signs. Like, I mean, this I can take it as a lot of signs and synchronicities also. The universe was giving you a lot of signs that it's high time that you end it, but probably you were not being able to do it. This could be your person's energy also. Okay, but I think this connection, or you each other's presence in each other's life, okay, your presence in theirs and theirs in yours, okay, has acted like an angel of strength, has acted like strength. If you see two lions here, I don't know, maybe some totem significance if you guys have. In fact, these two women also look pretty similar to me, and I feel that, it brings in a lot of courage with happiness in each other's lives for both of you. Okay. The point is, I think, so whoever is in a toxic relationship, I'm seeing, or in a toxic situation, I'm seeing that you had lost faith. I'm seeing that you had lost hope in your life. You probably did not even believe in anything any longer. You had become slow. You lost your mojo. But now, with this coming in, okay, I am seeing you slowly and steadily again embracing oneness with the universe. Again, starting to understand connections. Again, feeling love. Okay. Again, having hopes in life. So, one is courage, and the other, I'm also picking up hope. The connection kind of bringing in some sort of a hope in both of you. Okay. It's like I'm seeing a lot of respect, mutual respect for each other, and I think a lot of admiration as well. This pile is more about, like, just looking at each other and thinking that, oh wow, I mean, this is an incredible connection. And how much strength do I get from this? Okay. It's that sort of a feeling. This is the significance of this connection. This connection is acting like a pillar of strength for both of you in your respective lives. It is a beautiful, beautiful connection. Okay. I can literally see it. I'm not saying that you guys will land up in a marriage commitment, etc., etc. No, it's not always that. It's sometimes that you need someone's presence to catalyze an event, to make something happen. And this is exactly what this connection is doing. It's making this thing happen. It's making you release any kind of toxic relationship that doesn't serve you any longer. Or it's you are making them release. Please take it how it resonates. Okay. Actually, I have seven repeated twice, so definitely a spiritual number, spiritual pile. I'm seeing this connection to be extremely spiritual for both of you. Okay, it's like the divine watching you and telling you through this person. Okay, or you being that person. It's okay. You don't have to be like a super powerful being or an ascended master to be this way. No, nothing like that. It's just a normal human being just helping or catalyzing something for a person who could not do it all by himself or herself. And it's totally okay. It happens in life. Okay, so yeah, for pile number two, the biggest thing that I pick up here is that you both are like strength for each other to allow certain things to be released. Okay, some things to go away from your life which are toxic. Okay, which are toxic, which are no longer meant for you at all. So that's the energy that I pick up for you guys. Pile number two, clear quartz. That's the significance of this connection. And slowly I see you again believing. You are again believing in things that probably you had lost hope in. And it's important for you to kind of regain your hope, because hope is what keeps things going, right? So yeah, that's what I see for pile number two. Let me know in the comment section if this resonated with you guys. This is a beautiful pile. I hope you got your message and I hope you got the clarity. And whenever you're watching this, please take care of yourself, stay safe. And I hope that my messages bring in clarity for you. Okay, bye. Okay, so pile number three, the final pile, the amethyst. Now, what is the significance of this connection in your life? Actually, I have a raw amethyst here as well, and I am totally in love with it. Okay, so let's see, what's the significance? Paradisical, you belong to paradise. Okay, wow. Worth waiting for. Two of Pentacles, the Sun, Four of Cups, Ten of Cups. I'm sorry, guys. I don't know why I laughed. Okay. So I keep choosing. So today was like the first time I chose a pile for myself, and for the person that I had in my mind, I keep seeing Four of Cups for that person and it's back again here. Anyways, okay. Beautiful pile though. I'm sorry, I don't know why am I laughing. Maybe something there, I don't know. It's just a happy energy that I feel. Okay, so pile number three, what is the significance of this connection? This could be a person's energy, or this could be yours also. Please take it how it resonates. I'm sensing that your person, I'll just talk in the lingo of your person. If this is your energy, feel free to take it that way, because we're looking at a connection, significance of a connection. So two energies can come up, and whichever one is yours, you know. Okay. So I'm seeing that your person probably in their life in general wasn't sticking to one thing. Okay, they always were trying to do multitasking. Even in their love life, I feel emotionally they never shared with themselves with anyone. Okay, they were very withdrawn. I'm seeing people around them who wanted to give them love, but they never accepted it. Okay. And now I'm actually seeing that this was a subconscious weight that was there in your person's mind. This is basically I mean, not that. So, you know, when your mind and your heart just knows that, okay, this is not the one that I'm looking for. You know, like when you go to buy something, okay. I'm not saying, I mean, maybe your person might have had like a lot of relationships in the past. But there was something to do with emotional giving. They were not doing that. Okay. It started to rain just now. Okay. So maybe they were not giving themselves emotionally at all, because this was a subconscious weight, as I told you. What they are headed towards now, I am seeing that this weight is coming to an end. See, their expectations, okay, their expectations was not that they weren't clear. They knew what they want. Probably in their mind, the picture of love is also very clear in their mind, okay? But they probably just couldn't find it somehow, all right? And I can see now, with this connection coming into picture, they feel the happiness. They feel the happiness. Okay. And I think even you, I think it's a sync between the two of you. Even you were subconsciously waiting for something. Your person was also waiting for something. You both probably didn't know what were you exactly waiting for. But I'm seeing this wait to like literally come to an end now. It's worth waiting for. Divine timing is at work in your love life. Okay. So what I see over here is that finally the emotional fulfillment that both of you are looking for, you both will find it in each other. Okay. I am seeing that whatever your thoughts were, okay, whatever your thoughts were, I'm seeing they being answered. Okay. You paradisical, okay. Paradisiacal, you belong to paradise. That's basically if you or your person has been feeling that, you know, maybe what I'm waiting for is unreal, okay, if you've been getting those feelings that maybe this is just not something that can ever happen, I mean, what am I waiting for? Why doesn't my heart allow me to accept anything else? It's not like that. I think people who've chosen this pile, I think this is a very strong bond that the two of you have, but both of you are in denial, I feel. Could be. Either if you are not in denial, then your person is in denial, or if you are in denial, then can't say much. But yeah, I can literally see, I mean, two of you here, I can actually see one is refusing, the other one is juggling or something like that, okay? But please understand that both of you, okay, have literally waited for each other. That's why nothing was working out. That's why nothing was happening. Okay. With the Ten of Cups here, I feel that whatever the expectations were, okay, whatever thoughts were there, or whatever you thought or your person thought that this is what I want, is here. It is right here. Okay. But it's just about extending that hand and taking it. That is the, energy that is missing. So the significance of this connection in your life, I am seeing, is that your wait is over. The wait that you had been doing, or you'd been like literally thinking that, even if sometimes I have also experienced it. Sometimes you're just subconsciously waiting for something. Sometimes subconsciously you just don't know whether, should I accept this, or is there something better ahead? Sometimes you give in to peer pressure. You just think that, okay, whatever I'm getting, let me just grab it. But I think your energy is not like that. You haven't grabbed it. Okay. Maybe for the society or for the heck of it, you have. But in general, I don't see that you have grabbed it or anything like that. Okay. But the happiness that you've been looking for, or the emotional contentment that you've been seeking, is here. It is here. You just need to extend your hand. I can literally I see a vision. I see like two people just thinking a little too much than required about the situation. Okay. The situation is not as complicated as you guys think. It is just about being a little more vulnerable and taking a decision. Okay. So that's something that I pick up for you guys. So significance wise, I told you it is worth waiting for. And what you were waiting for is this 10 of cups and it's here. This connection is this, your wait. Okay. Whatever you were waiting for. All right. Okay. So that's what I see here for pile number 3. Do let me know in the comments if this resonated with you, because this seems to me like a very nice energy. In fact, all 3 piles today have been very beautiful, calm energy today. So I'm glad that I did this reading and I hope that this brought in the insight that you were looking for. Take care. Bye.